Captain, quick! You'll hurt Captain!
You'll have to show me how to do that.
Thank you. hiding where those researchers had their hideout. You think we can get inside? This must have been where those researchers had their hideout. You think we can get inside?
Thank you. anger a man of the cloth.
Quite enough of you!
Yeah!
This facility is currently experiencing a heightened security event. Accessing this facility requires voice-modulated passphrase. Please speak the passphrase.
We attest to the zest with our hand on our chest. Be impressed as our guest by what we finessed. You are blessed to ingest what we thoroughly test. You've tried the best, now try the rest. Spacer's choice.
Passphrase accepted. Access granted. Welcome, Dr. Jasper Lowe.
Hard to believe something so awful as Adrena Time came from a place that looks so normal. Normal aside from the bodies, I mean. And the blood. Oh, so much blood.
Hold on. I thought this place was supposed to be abandoned. You think that could have been the spooky voice from OCI? The one calling themselves the ghost?
defeat. Nice.
Roscoe, it's Georgie. If you're hearing this, you must still be holed up at the Sprat Shack. And you're not gonna like this one bit. I was trying to steal our recordings when things went crazy. I know. Like I said, sorry. And I'm gonna be in a heap of trouble if I don't get them, so if you wanna save my bacon, you need to do it for me. I need the 3 interviews we did with Ambrose, this one here, plus another recording of my own. I left that last one with a guy who owed me a favor at the garbage processing office in the chemical waste ravine. I'll leave an automech near Stellar Freighting. It'll want all 5 recordings, plus a passphrase. Glacial Age. Oh, and don't listen to my log, all right? Just stay safe and keep your head down.
Quite enough of you! Pass that armor! Nice one!
Not very sanitary anymore, if it ever was.
How the devil do I use this thing? Is it what? Oh, the barrel's turning. All right. I feel like an absolute idiot barking into this horn. I shouldn't have let Lucien talk me into this. What use do I have with audible notes? Posterity my ass. Ah, great fucking law. What's it doing now? Jasper, it's... How do I turn it off? It won't...
Just press the button.
The what?
Oh, for law's sake, the button, Ollie.
Accursed thing.
Find peace in death.
The effects of Compound X are inescapable. The refined excrement of the xenocyte life form. It's a fine powder, very fine. It finds its way into absolutely everything, even in the water now and the air. It settles like a veil over all of Gorgon. The laboratory techs get the worst of it. We all appreciated the boost to mood and productivity at first, but We're at each other's throats in an instant now. I've had to break up 2 fistfights this week alone. This aggression must be inherent to the formula. The Compound X. How do I stop it?
Careful. Seems like they had a surplus of traps they decided to get rid of all in one place.
Processing.
Here's a little trick I learned in prison.
Understood. I'll keep my head down. I wonder if this is where Lo was when his mind was pushed to its breaking point.
Now.
Primals, too? They wanted to make sure they made all the bad decisions, didn't they?
especially after I've gone to so much effort to see Gorgon rest in peace. It's a good thing, then, that I finally figured out what you're after. I'll see you soon, little weasel.
Is it just me, or does it seem like our mysterious nemesis watches too many Aetherwave serials?
This is sick. I can't bear it any longer.
Though I suppose it's always dark here in the void. The lab is empty, and I am at last alone. I'm preoccupied with thoughts of the single-celled xenocytes that make their home here on this rock. These primordial creatures persist despite the hostility of their surroundings. No, they require adversity to thrive. Perhaps that's why our bodies react to theirs. There is a harmony in us. The law didn't craft us for the void, yet we scrabble across its cold worlds, building, persisting, as the xenocytes do. We live. Against all odds, we live. But for how long?
since we've been traveling together, we've visited a lot of places that set my teeth on edge. This here makes my skin crawl.
I dare say it seems like the inmates were running the asylum here. The only thing they seem to be able to get right is sowing insanity and destroying people's lives. This whole project wrought mental destruction on everyone involved, including themselves. All brought to you by Spacer's Choice's best and brightest.
That might have been enough for me back in Edgewater. But after all we've seen of Halcyon? Captain, someone should have said no. I get now why Miss Ambrose would want to clear her mom's name. If the folks responsible for Edgewater's woes tried to blame him on my dad, I couldn't have let it stand.
I'd have hoped a smart fellow like Mr. Lowe would know better than to test his super drug on primals. Be a relief to see the stars again. This cave is making me all jumpy.
Thank you. Hey, there you are. Been wondering how you were doing. Did you manage to find those recordings? Sure, I'm an open book. Nice enough guy. Fashioned himself one of those professional gumshoes, like in the serials. They usually work for the board, rooting out dissidents and the like. Lucky, though, he was freelance. Worked for anyone who paid, no matter their allegiance. You ask me, I think the guy just likes snooping around in folks' terminal messages. No, but I'd wager Lex there's a lot of weird shit she doesn't tell anyone about. That's the sublight way. Gotta say, though, mailing a stranger some dead guy's arm probably tops the list. At least I'd hope so. Frenetic, chaotic, vicious, take your pick. I wasn't here at the start, but going off what folks told me about the early days, Gorgon started out with promise. The board's best and brightest were excited to work here, said it was a good posting. The project director had a vision and big, bold ideas. Nothing good lasts long in Halcyon. Thing is, the schedules coming out of the corporate office were unrealistic from the get-go, and they were trying to do the project on a shoestring budget. Couple that with the obvious personnel problems and toxic junk in the product, it was only a matter of time before it all went to hell. Could have been, yeah. Marauders didn't just fall out of the sky one day. They were made here on Gorgon. How, though? That's the question. Spratshack legend has it they crawled out of the mines one day. Heard one fella suggest they might even be aliens. I think the drug they were developing here turned people into marauders. Not on purpose, mind, but over time. Marauderhood's not the flu. It ain't contagious and they don't reproduce. So how else would they get all over the colony?
Seems a little far-fetched, don't it? Spacer's choice, just letting that happen to the folks they're meant to keep safe?
I don't have proof, mind. It's just a hunch. Adrenatime, I'm sure you know it, was a drug, something to make folks work harder, work smarter. Had a lot of nasty side effects. Didn't seem so bad to me at the time, but then I hadn't met the test subjects yet. The whole thing was real hush-hush. A lot of worry about corporate spies, especially from Anticleos. I probably shouldn't even be mentioning it to you, to be honest. Spacer's choice? They're really not fond of spies. Shit, any number of things. Fire, primals, sabotage. It didn't happen all at once, but it happened fast enough folks couldn't respond in time. Now, if you're asking how it all kicked off, might have been spies that did it. Corporate espionage, you know. Anticleos. I never did figure it out. Not about to try now. Not a problem. Anything else? Well, I'll be damned. Now I can finally get off this rock and go home. I know it's not much, but take the last of my bits. You've earned every single one, friend. My pockets? Oh, sure. Here's a few more bits for your trouble. Call it hazard pay. No, I mean, I don't know. Sometimes it seemed like there could be, when we were servicing the phonographs, we're sharing a beer, but who'd be interested in some forgotten old bastard like me? Ha, sure. Nice of you to say. Sorry, not much in the mood for a witty repartee, what with the world-shattering revelations and all. Any other horrible truths you want to reveal to me? Or can I get back to my drinking? She couldn't have been. We were together all the time. Except, oh shit, my weekly calls with headquarters. What could she even want to ask Olivia Ambrose about? Doesn't make sense. Good fucking law. Headquarters would kill me if they knew, right after they killed her. Hell, Being stuck here might have been the only thing keeping me alive. Listen, I appreciate you telling me what happened with those recordings, but I need some time to think. Got a lot to process. Yeah, I'll just... yeah. See you around.
Synthesis and Manufacturing Center, huh?
Let's move quick and stick together. Ain't no one dying on my watch.
Welcome to the Adrenatime Synthesis and Manufacturing Center, brought to you by Spacer's Choice. This productivity auto-mechanical unit is at your disposal. Its normal duties involve the management of legacy operations analytics. However, due to the promotion, demotion, death, or injury to other managers of this facility, this unit is now the acting manager of the following departments: Reception, Human Resources, Accounting, Technical Support, Manufacturing, Distribution, Security. Please direct any questions about those departments to Pam. Answers not guaranteed. According to this facility's hierarchy, there are 0 acting managers at this Spacer's Choice facility. Not to worry. If a middle manager cannot immediately be replaced, Pam can safely oversee 3.176 departments. When you're in a productivity pinch, Pam can pick up the pieces. Uh-oh, it looks like there are intruders in this facility. Protocol recommends speaking to the head of facility security right away. Management stretched thin? That's okay. With safety protocols disabled, Pam can manage 12.678 departments with an estimated worker fatality rate of only 4.83 per week. After all, Pam's purpose is to answer one question. How can I increase your productivity today? Did you know that keeping your workers alive boosts productivity? That's why every Pam unit comes equipped with the latest Spacer's Choice weaponry. When Pam's emergency combat protocols are activated, your investments are sure to be protected. Warning: due to power consumption, Combat protocols cannot be activated when Pam's power is below 73% without deactivating managerial processes. Spacer's choice policy dictates that managerial processes take priority. This unit's power rating is 57%. Hate messing with tangled cables or confusing batteries? With Pam, you'll never have to. Just pop in a Firefly brand industrial strength battery, and Pam's ready to go. Out of batteries and need productivity now? No problem. Just hook Pam's power source up to another automechanical, and Pam will get your employees back in line in no time. Pam is fully customizable to fit your preferred management style. With the correct override codes, you can alter any of Pam's behaviors at will. Some limitations apply. Spacer's Choice does not accept legal responsibility for any injuries or trauma sustained after altering Pam's behaviors. See manual for details. Emergency combat protocols cannot be engaged at less than 73% power without proper authorization. Please ensure that this unit is fully charged or present your override password.
I could give it a shot. Let me just... Okay. Weird way to do that, but there ain't no accounting for sense. There we go. All I had to do was convince this old girl here that 73% was the new 100%. Easy as salt tuna and sawdust pie.
This unit's power rating is 100%. Great! Emergency combat protocols are now available. Error. Employee's biometric ID does not match this unit's designated manager. Proceeding with verbal management test. Pretend that this PAM unit is one of your employees who has been working long hours. What would you say to give them an extra pep pill in their step? Like any good manager, Pam comes equipped with an emergency pep pill dispenser. Employees passing out at their desk is a thing of the past. Verbal management test complete. Result. Employee is a Spacer's Choice manager. 94% certainty. Engaging emergency combat protocols. Stand by.
Thank you.
No, wait. That head's not spinning all the way around, is it? Well, that's not unsettling at all.
If I didn't know better, I'd swear it was watching me.
For unauthorized persons.
do that. Don't mess with us.
Nice one.
Watch your hands, Captain. Be a bad time to lose them. Well, I guess any time would be a bad time, but especially now.
A man of the claw.
A deft hand with a magpie.
Is it weird if this thing kind of reminds me of the OSI building back in Edgewater? I could sort of...
To think, I would once have been impressed by this monstrosity.
Finally, get that journal and get the heck out of here.
Great work.
is mine. Go now, and I will not pursue you. But if you stay, I will sick every last lawless fucking mercenary in Halcyon on you. It's your choice, Captain.
Never know safety again? And why should the future be any different from the past?
Starting to hope I get to meet this jerk. Just so I can give him a good kick in the shins.
We are receiving an incoming signal, Captain.
Captain, I see you've made some headway on Gorgon. Mother's old work terminal just lit up with a bunch of new protocols. Very exciting. What about Mother's journal? Any progress there? Are you accusing me of deception? Captain, I would never. Can you hear me, Captain? I'm getting some interference on my end. Captain. Captain!
Hello again, little weasel. I must admit, you've surprised me. I threw nearly everything I had at you, and you overcame it all. spotted, Captain. We've both played our roles well, but it seems you've got the edge. I may have gravely underestimated you. You were smart to hire him, Wilhelmina. Well done.
Mother! You're alive! And still on Gorgon? I thought she was. Who ever thought a lone scientist could survive for 5 years on Gorgon? This is so you, Mother. Inserting yourself where you aren't needed and at the worst possible time.
Am I disrupting your vanity project, you empty-headed little twit?
Mother is going to fill your head with lies about me and Gorgon. Don't listen. Have you come back just to ruin everything again, Mother? At least this time I have the power to stop you.
Captain, this is a distraction. Let's set our differences aside and focus on what matters. Adrena time must never be revived.
Adrena time didn't create marauders, mismanagement did. By now, you realize that Project Gorgon was devoted to a single drug, Adrena time. A drug that hit the market in spite of calamitous side effects. Because they believed it could help Halcyon. I still believe it can. The project was a colossal failure, but you and I are going to revive it from the ashes. Adrena time was a lie. Our drug will fulfill its broken promise for workers and employers across the colony. Mother wasn't equal to the task. Thankfully for us both, I'm not my mother. What you've seen is the result of Mother's leadership. I have no intention of repeating her mistakes. Mother's journal contains the activation codes for the Adrena Time synthesizer, the key to a new Project Gorgon. We're going to start again, and this time with everything Project Gorgon didn't have. Better R&D, better scientists, clear goals, more funding, and a timeline that makes sense. Who else? Spacer's choice. After I showed them the error of their ways, the corporation couldn't wait to restart the project. If I can improve the chemistry, I can fix Adrena time. We can put this colony back on track together.
Finally, a sensible question. I am the head of Project Gorgon. Its grand mastermind. I created Adrena time because I believed, arrogantly, foolishly, that I could uplift the common man through chemistry. I failed. Now my daughter wants to take up my mantle. Don't be absurd. Minnie is a bright enough girl, but she's weak, flighty. She'd abandon the project at the first minor setback. My work has already destroyed countless lives. We can't let her do so again out of pride and sentiment.
What about my life, Mother? The Ambrose name has no dignity anymore. I can't even show my face around Byzantium without being the gossip of the town. It's no laughing matter, Captain. What good can I do if I have no influence? How can I fix society if I can't even take out a loan? Every day, workers slump over from exhaustion. The gears of industry swallow them whole, and no one is coming to help. Adrena time is the break we can't fit into the schedule. The office with a window we can't afford to build. It's the best this rotten colony can do for people. It's a bandage, not a cure. Halcyon is wounded, and I will do everything in my power to stop the bleeding.
Don't let those bloodless leeches at Spacer's Choice walk you down this perilous path, Wilhelmina. You haven't the fortitude to endure it.
As usual, Mother projects her failures onto me. If she had let me get involved from the start, we might have avoided this calamity altogether. Enlighten me. You've seen Gorgon up close. So tell me, what exactly is so insurmountable that we shouldn't even try?
Precisely. Compound X gets into everything. Air, water, food. Over time, you and everyone you work with will suffer its effects. You will watch the people you love become monsters.
Progress demands sacrifice. We are in the middle of a crisis that will tear this colony apart. And you two are splitting hairs. If I can save the colony and redeem the Ambrose family name, I owe it to myself to try. Mother be damned. Social engineering takes generations, and we don't have the luxury of time. We need to mainline progress into Halcyon's bloodstream. You've seen more of this colony than the average grunt. You know as well as I do that this is a question of survival. With Adrena time, we can increase worker productivity orders of magnitude above ordinary stems, and risk none of the harmful side effects. Imagine if we flooded the market with drugs that actually helped people. We could influence the very business model of Spacer's Choice. We won't be exploiting workers any longer. We'll be celebrating them, giving them everything they need to succeed.
No, this is madness. The project, the complex, it has to be destroyed, razed to the ground. It's the only way.
I need that facility online, but I can't do it while Mother's still a problem. By now, she'll have shut down the Gorgon reactor. Deal with her however it suits you, and get that facility back up and running.
Don't do this, Wilhelmina. Minnie, don't make this choice.
Adrena time is our future. It's bigger than money, bigger than family. It's the colony's best hope. If Mother tries to get in your way, you have my permission to defend yourself, no matter the cost.
This is absurd. You must end this madness, Captain. I thought you were a part of Minnie's ploy, her ally in this mad, selfish scheme to resurrect Adrena time. But now that I understand she was lying to you, I find I want your help. I'm sorry for trying to kill you, Captain. I should have been honest with you from the start. You've shown yourself more than capable of handling all that Gorgon and I could throw at you. You might be the only one with the mettle to put Gorgon down for good. Return to my family's manor, Captain. Use the executive override code in my journal to activate the NDA protocol for my terminal. It will destroy the Gorgon drug synthesizer and put an end to Adrena time for good. Don't pretend you haven't seen its effects with your own eyes, here and elsewhere. We live in a vicious world, Captain, and Adrena time is to blame. I should have smothered it in its crib at the start. Consider quickly. Wilhelmina will not stand idly by while you scuttle her best-laid plans. She will try to force you to fight her. You don't have to. In fact, I would ask you not to. Whatever mistake she might make, she is still my daughter.
Captain, in light of recent events, I'm putting the manor under lockdown. Until Mother is dealt with, anyone who lands here is presumed hostile. Finish the job. I know you won't disappoint me.